mortals join the mighty chorus which the morning stars began. Love divine is reigning o'er us, leading us with mercy's hand. Ever singing march we onward, victors in the midst of strife. Joyful music leads us sunward in the triumph song of life.
Well, it's going to be children's moment. But one thing I want you to do, when the service is over, the service isn't over. Please stay seated. There's more coming. So,
if the children would come forward for the children's moment. Hi, Chesney. You're fine. You've always been fine. Yeah. Oh, look at you guys. Look how handsome you are. Look how pretty you are, Harper. Oh, thanks, you guys. Oh. Oh, hold on now. Slow down. Whoa.
I want to tell you guys.
That's hot.
Oh, thank you, Nolan.
I want to tell you something, Justin.
Okay. Oh, pretty. Thank you, Jasmine.
I'm on the paper.
You're on the paper?
It says, free kindergarten parents tripping ocean door. If you was in Paris, would I could have like pancakes with syrup? What would you buy with $1 million, a water squirt gun? Where would you go on a trip? Hawaii, where I could swim. What's your favorite thing at recess? I like to go to the slides. What do you want to be, a firefighter?
Wow, Joshua. That's an impressive list, brother. Can I have the picture you made for me?
This is...
Was that for someone else?
I already gave you one.
Oh, you already gave me one? Okay. Which one is it? I want to see yours.
This one.
Oh, look at that, a rainbow and a cross. We will miss you. We will miss you, Chesney. Well, you guys are very good artists. You know, for the last 12 years, probably about 550 children's messages.
Whoa!
Yeah, believe me, some mornings I said, whoa. Thank you, Krista. We will miss you from Carolyn.
Krista.
Is that for Krista? Thank you, Justin and Krista. We will miss you from Carolyn. Very good. Thank you, Carolyn. And thank you, Justin and Krista. Oh, it's from Harper. Thank you, Harper. I like that. And this one's from Harper. God bless Pastor every day and all he does at work or play. Thank you for all he taught us of God's love and of Jesus, his son, who lives above. Thank you for reminding us to do great things for God. And almost every Sunday, I've said to you, what have I said to you? You're going to do great things for God. That's right. You're going to do great things for God. And I believe that. I believe that. Now, you know, one of the things that I've been thinking about, Jesus blessed the children. He only had 3 years. That's all the years of ministry he had. And he would take children on his knees and he would bless them. He would teach them, he'd love on them and hug them and tell them how much God loves him, how much his father loved him, how much he loved him. And so today, I brought you stone hearts. Hearts that will never rot. Hearts that will never break. Hearts of stone. To remind you, first of all, how much I love you, but more importantly, how much Jesus loves you.
It's like Jesus has like a stone heart that never breaks.
Well, yep, his heart's not stone. But the reason I gave you these is that I wanted to get you something that you could not bust or break. all right? Because I know little boys, all right? Now, Harper? Harper, this is your stone. All right, come up here. Harper, you have been a very observant, thoughtful, kind, beautiful spirit. You have a beautiful heart, just like this one. And I want you to keep following Jesus with all your heart. That's your stone. Carolyn? Here's your heart. You are a very smart girl. You're very obedient. You loved to run and laugh. When mom lets you. And you're going to do great things for God. You have a beautiful heart too. But I want you to always remember how much Jesus loves you forever and ever. There's nothing you can do to stop his love for you. That's your heart. The heart of God. Chesney. You know why I picked this stone for you? Because you have a great big heart. You are a prayer warrior. I've never seen such a little girl since my daughter pray as much as you pray. You talk to God. You listen for God. You're obeying God. Every time you obey mom and dad, you miss your grandpa. I understand that. I miss my grandpa too. But this is a heart for you to stay pure and holy and keep praying. Keep praying. Keep listening. Keep talking to God, okay?
I'm going to keep it in a special place.
I hope so. I'm going to keep you in a special place. Right in here. Sure. Nolan? There's only one kind of heart for you. Oh, it's red. For a red-blooded American boy like you. Okay? Yeah. You're full of energy. You're full of love. You're a wonderful big brother to little Raina. You're a great little brother to Chesney. And you are going to do great things for God. You keep listening and learning, so that your heart inside of you keeps growing to be more like Jesus. To be more like Jesus, okay?
It sticks out of my body.
I hope it will stick out of your body. Every time that you do an act of love to somebody, like this, come here. Come here. Every time you do something like this, your heart sticks out. Your heart sticks out. All right. God bless you, Nolan. Thea. Thea, Thea, I got you another white heart, pure, holy. I don't know you as well as the other children. I wish I could have had more time with you, but your name is so close to Theos, which is the Greek word for God. Thea, Theos. And I know that you're a very smart, you're very spiritual. You're learning, you're growing into being more like Jesus. So keep your heart always pure and holy for God, okay? And God bless you. Soren, I'm going to give you a choice. You want the big blue heart or the little blue heart? You want the little blue heart? This is your little heart. And like Thea, I don't know you real well, but I tell you what, a few months ago, you would not have been standing here talking to me. You'd have been up here with Mommy. But look how much you're growing and blossoming. You're becoming a little man. You keep your little heart close. You keep listening for Jesus in your heart. Okay? That's for you, Soren. God bless you. Joshua. Joshua, I got you a big kind of purplish red heart. Stand over here. Joshua, you are a wonderful, wonderful boy. And your heart is so open to God. And you know something I saw the other day that shows me that you have this great big compassionate heart is when you tried to console that girl at the soccer game, she was so upset. And you walked over and said, it's going to be okay. And then you scored a goal for their team to help them out. He did. He did, and he did it on purpose. Because he didn't want them to feel bad. Boy, we need more Joshuas in the world, don't we? So Joshua, this is your big red heart, because you've got a big heart. And you just keep thinking, you keep growing, and you keep your heart open to Jesus, okay? And remember that Jesus loves you, and I'm the first person. Look at me. Look at me. We were out by the big shed at Camp Quaker Heights, and I yelled your name. You were only about this tall. I yelled your name, Joshua, and it echoed off the woods and came back, and you went, Joshua, Joshua. I'll never forget that moment. Blessings upon you, Joshua. Love you. Okay. What I did with the traditional candy, it was right here. Oh, would you like to, guys, ladies, would you like to come up and get a piece of candy? And thank you so much for your beautiful artwork. That is so nice of you. Come here. You're welcome. Okay, boys. That's you, Nolan. Now, if we can get the PowerPoint to work with music, you children, I want you to pay attention to the PowerPoint because you may be up, you may be, your picture may be up there on that screen, okay? Yeah, why not? For the, I hope the PowerPoint will work for us because I've got 20 minutes of music, and that's going to basically be the sermon. I do want to say that I was very saddened about the loss of Martha Eckhart, and when I first came here 12 years ago, I did not know how to interpret her. And those of you that knew her knew exactly what I'm talking about. She told me where to stand. She told me how to pray. And then as I got to know her more deeply, I understood that underneath that kind of gruff, direct exterior was a heart of gold underneath there. And I will never forget two things. I walked into the fellowship hall one day and she was kind of barking at me. And so I just walked right up and I kissed her. And that was the end of it. That was the end of her barking at me. It was me kissing her on the cheek. She hadn't had a kiss on her cheek for I don't know how long. But, and the other thing that I'll always remember, she always felt sorry for the Quaker women of this meeting because they didn't know what a good beer tasted like. And anyway, gonna miss Martha. This first song, if we can get things to rolling, and oh, I really need a drink of water. Thank you, Terry. Is about God's view of us. And as we got done blessing the children this morning, always be a child. Thank you.
crying, Father, I have sinned. I picked you up and held you close again. You will always be a child in my eyes. And when you need some love, my arms are open wide. And even when you're growing old, I hope you realize you will always be a child in my eyes. You will always be a child in my eyes. And when you need some love, my arms are open wide. Even when you're growing old, I hope you realize you will always be a child in my eyes. You will always be a child in my
You are my friends if you do what I command you, said Jesus. Let's continue to follow Jesus and let's continue to be friends. This last song, it's a song of gratitude from me to you, the way that many of you have changed my life for the better. So I want to thank you.
You were there with me. We walked upon the streets of gold beside the crystal sea. We heard the angels singing and someone called your name. You turned and saw this young man and he was smiling as he came. And he said, friend, you may not know me now. Then he said, but wait. You used to teach my Sunday school when I was only 8. And every week you would say a prayer before the class would start. And one day when you said your prayer, I asked Jesus in my heart. Before you, he said, remember the time a missionary came to your church. His pictures made you cry. You didn't have much money, but you gave it anyway. Jesus took the gift you gave, that's why I'm here today. Somehow touched by your generosity, little things that you had done, sacrifices made, unnoticed on the earth, in heaven now proclaimed. I know up in heaven you're not supposed to cry, but I am almost sure there were tears in your eyes as Jesus took your hand and you stood before the Lord. He said, my child, look around you. Great is your reward. Giving to the Lord, I am a life that was changed. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am so glad you gave.
I thank my God every time I remember you, writes Paul to the little groups of Christians in the city of Philippi. In all my prayers for all of you, I always pray with joy because of your partnership in the gospel from the first day 12 years ago until now. Being confident of this, that he who began a beautiful work in you shall see it to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. And this is my prayer, that your love may abound more and more in knowledge and in depth of insight, so that you may be able to discern what is best and may be pure and blameless until the day of Christ, filled with the fruit of righteousness that comes through Jesus Christ, to the glory and praise of God. That's my prayer, my thoughts for you, my dear friends. I pray that your love will abound more and more deeply, and that your souls and my soul will continue to enlarge and become more like Jesus Christ. That we'd be filled with mercy and kindness and forgiveness and grace and great joy. Great joy. I want to really thank those people who allowed me to be their pastor. Not just their chaplain. Not just their patsy. But to be your pastor. Those of you who let me into your hearts as I let you into mine, where we shared eternal things, deep things, painful things, joyful things. I was thinking just this morning, how many different rooms I've been in. Kitchens, back porches, camp offices, hog confinement systems. Thank you, Jeff Cook. Hospital rooms. Rooms where families gathered to sorrow. Rooms where we waited in anticipation as someone was going through a major procedure. Rooms where we spent time together in Christ, sharing, being together, just loving on each other. I want to say that the other thing I want to say, so very straightforward, is that I thank you so deeply for praying my family and myself through 2 years ago. Without your prayers, your love, your support of Krista and Jonathon and Rachel, who knows what would have happened? The fellowship of believers, loving and caring for each other. And I know that when I came out of that hospital, I was not the same person. In some ways, I'm better. In other ways, my memory is not. But I want to thank you for loving on us and supporting us through that very, very difficult time. I hope that through the 600 plus sermons that were preached, the 500 and some children's messages, the 400 and some Bible studies that were offered, all the times I've made myself available, at least I tried to, I hope that you saw Jesus somewhere along the line in me. I've seen Jesus in you, the Christ. And I am confident, just as Paul said, if you keep your hearts open, if we keep listening to the voice of the true shepherd who calls us by name, he will complete his work in us until the day of Christ Jesus. A part of our hearts will always be here. I know that we're not physically relocating. You're always welcome to call us, to stop by. We do not want to be in any way unapproachable. But I've made clear about the dynamics of after today that I will not be doing any kind of formal ministry, because you guys need to pull together, and you're already pulling together, and your next pastor doesn't need someone to interfere. So that's my goal. And anything that I do organically is going to be to complement churches, not to be in competition with churches. So just know that if I offer something, you're more than welcome, but I'm not here to replace anything of any church, whether it's the Baptists, the Methodists, the Congos, or whomever. But God is doing new things. Can you see it? Can you perceive it? Ask the prophet Isaiah. God is always doing new things. Let us move into God's fresh future in the ways that we're called. Again, thank you. Thank you, thank you. Let's spend a, oh my goodness, it's 5 till 11. Let's spend a few moments in the quiet. And power of Christ rest in your hearts. And thank you again. Thank you, thank you.
Just to stay here for just a few minutes. We have a short program of appreciation that we would thought would be easier to do here in the sanctuary so everyone could see and hear rather than to try to do it in a crowded dining room. So just hold on a second. Okay, Justin and Krista, would you come up here, please? Jonathon and Rachel, would you just stand where you are, please? Would you just stand around so everybody could see your beautiful faces for me? We just want to say as a congregation that we're really proud of you two, and it's been a real blessing to watch you grow up among us for 12 years. We know, well, we don't know, but maybe some people know how tough it is to be a preacher's kid in today's world and to grow up with kind of tough expectations. And you two have made us proud. You're beautiful people. And we just wish you all the success in the world, Rachel, as you graduate now from UNI and go into a new career in human services, right? Yeah. And Jonathon, as you continue your wonderful career in the East Coast and NFL sports. And, We just want you to know that we as a congregation are here. We love you, we support you, and we'll be praying for you wherever you are. So thank you.
Thank you, Jane.
Now we have just a few people. I know there are many of you who have words of appreciation you would like to express, but I've just asked just a few people to stand and or either come forward and speak at the microphone or stand where you are, and I will introduce them and you can say your words. First we have Mindy.
Well, for us, I can remember you guys coming because I was hugely pregnant with Jordan, and she's going to be 12 this summer. And Justin, you've been the only pastor my girls have known. You've dedicated both of them, and you and Krista both have been great support to our family. And I asked the kids of memories that they had, and the big kids, remember when you guys went shopping this last winter? Caden's memory was, Justin, you found a Barbie dream car camper that you really thought that Krista needed. And when you brought it to her, Krista's like, go put that back. And Caden also remembers you guys supporting him at football games, freezing football games, and sweltering fair events for both of the kids. You guys have been great support for them. Jordan's memory was also, so they were shopping for the family across the street for Christmas for two little boys, and they were looking for puzzles, and they couldn't find puzzles. Where are the puzzles? Where are the puzzles? And Justin stops in the middle of the aisle and says loudly, does anybody know where the puzzles are? And Jordan and Elizabeth were... So the fact that you can show them laughter and growing them in Christ. We are really appreciative for you guys. Dustin's memory was when you prayed for him when he was going to Haiti because you knew what he was going to encounter there. Mm-hmm. And he also remembers your very first sermon of being good for nothing. And that's really impacted him. For me,
I know what yours is.
When you guys came to my dad's funeral, driving 5 hours one way to support me and seeing your faces meant so much to me. And we just love you guys.
Love you.
And appreciate the support and laughter and kindness and the words of encouragement, the phone calls of, Mindy, this is Justin Weber. Yep, it is. We really appreciate you guys and love you and look forward to other gatherings. And
yeah.
We love you guys.
Yeah, love you guys. Thank you, Annalise.
Terry?
I was honored to be on the church committee when Justin was interviewing. I knew he would be a blessing to our meeting. I'd appreciate it as a pastor, but more so as a friend. I felt like I could be vulnerable and talk to him about anything, something I had not felt before with any other pastor. We shared laughter, tears, and joy. He reminded me that Jesus loved me no matter what. Mm. While picking with him, I learned to be more open to witness my faith. We would pray with waitresses at restaurants. He'd take time to listen to customers who wanted to talk, and then we'd pray with them. Justin is a model of how to live out our faith. Thank you, Pastor Weber. We love you, and we love your family. Mm-hmm.
Mary. So many things I could say, but I really want to thank you for, Justin, for the Bible studies. I have learned so much and been able to understand so much more of the context, the location, it's been an amazing thing for me, and I really want to share my appreciation for that in particular. Also for the hospital visitation. When Don had his heart attack, he was going off for a procedure, an angiogram, to determine if they needed to do a stent or something more, and Justin was there. All the crew came in from the operating room with the cart, and Justin said, "Let's all join hands. We take hands in this group and pray." And what a witness that was to all of those hospital staff, and there were several in the room, and to us as well. It just was a very special moment that I've not forgotten. And I've appreciated the music ministry in particular, too. Yeah. Just love to hear you sing and have been uplifted by that. And there's so many more things I could go on. But
Go ahead.
Okay. I thank you, Krista, for all that you've done. Quietly, behind the scenes, things that we probably don't all even know about, but doing the children's church and the nursery and so many things. So appreciate both of you and look forward to what's next for both of you. So thank you, Mary. Thank you.
Mary and Don came from a town that we pastored, the Friends Church there, Ridge Farm, Illinois. And so we have a connection through Don's relatives, but they both lived there for a while. So it was neat to, Don and Mary Humrick House. I know what the Humrick House name. There's a little town called Humrick House, Humrick, there next to out east of Ridge Farm, and it's named after his family. And so it was really a great connection, and
yeah. We've
had a great time.
We were never there at the time Justin pastored, but I called as many people as I could remember to get, because I was on the search committee, and I heard a lot of wonderful things. And Justin told me later, he said, "I understand you were looking, trying to dig up dirt." And I said, "I was, but I didn't find any."
Oh, right here.
Jean.
Trying to hold it together here. I appreciate everything you've done for my family. You helped me bury my dad, my mom, my brother. You checked on Myrna and I when we were sick. You stood outside Myrna's window and talked to her. And after brother died, there's times you talked to me, and I appreciate that so much.
Thanks for sharing your family with me.
And thank you, Krista, for stepping up on Christian Ed when we needed some pursuit. Thank you.
Thank you, Jean.
Last but not least, we have Jane. Could we get a microphone over to her, Rex? Jane, we'll get a microphone if you'd... Yeah, we're getting a mic. Just hold on, Jane.
It's been a real blessing to have you both with us, and some things that went through my mind. Justin, I've really been thankful for your knowledge of the Bible. and being in Bible study and also sermon, you know, way above me. But he knows so much, just different things, how they relate from Old Testament to New Testament and all over. And that's been a real blessing. These sermons are always challenging, and I've appreciated those and his children's sermons. Probably I learned more from those. They're a little simpler sometimes. I've appreciated your sense of humor. Always happy, joyful, greeting people. And how caring you've been in the community and in our church for the elderly, for people that are in the hospital, the many, many calls that he has made. There's two things that I remember specifically. One was a couple of days after the derecho, and a neighbor up the street from me, everybody was working on the street, cleaning up and so forth. And the neighbor came over, sat down in the living room. She was crying, she was upset. We'd been without electricity. And so I just listened to her and we prayed and so forth. She is a cooker. She had lots of things in the freezers. She had two or three freezers, I think. And they didn't have a generator. And finally she said, well, I think I better head back home. And we got out on the front porch and here comes Justin's truck loaded with generators, heading right there. And that was a real blessing, Justin.
I like pie.
I will. She said she gave you a kiss. Another is sometimes Dick would call or else I'd be over at his house and he'd say, oh, I hear a motor out in front of my house. And we'd go look, or he'd go look, and here was Justin cleaning off the snow off of his sidewalk. And he didn't live that close. I said, well, did he drive the snowblower all the way over here? I don't know, he said, but he would just show up. And he did that for lots of people. And you were just very caring. Also your singing at the nursing homes has been a real blessing to many, many of the elderly. Your musical talent has been a blessing there and here very much. And funerals, you find out so much about the people who passed on and pass it on to us. And that has meant a lot too. And also I know that your place of business has been a mission place and you've shown Christ to many people there. Grateful for that. You've been a caring husband and father. Got two great kids. And then Krista, I know you told us when you came and interviewed here, you know, I'm not out in the forefront. And so quietly, you've cared for children and babies and worked on the Christian Ed Committee. And that has just been a blessing, I know, to parents. In a summary, I would like to quote from Paul saying in Ephesians 1:16, I've not stopped giving thanks for you, remembering you in my prayers. I'll always remember you and thankful for you guys.
Thank you, Jane. A brand new car.
Sorry, it wouldn't fit in the bag. We just have a small token of appreciation we want to give you. Would you like, maybe you'd like to read the card and then it makes sense and then you can open from the congregation.
Justin and Krista, it is with our gratitude and love that we thank you for the many ways you have cared for us and ministered among us during the past 12 years. You will always have a special place in our hearts, your friends at HCNP. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. $14.95. Can you see the heart, children? See the heart? Kind of where the tag is? Thank you, guys.
Yep.
John is going to come and pray a blessing over you and ask a blessing for our meal. And then at the close of that, we would ask you all just to stay in here while the servers can go out and get set up a little bit, and then we'll give the word when it's time to come and eat. John, thank you.
A lot of what I thought I'd share has already been shared, so I'm not going to share anymore in that regard. Let's join me then as we just talk to God as we continue our worship here. Father, we just humble ourselves before you here this morning. We want to lift you up, exalt you to all the people and all the nations. Justin has been great in sharing that and exemplifying that love and teaching us to grow closer and closer to you, to live more like you as we go about our daily activities. You've heard a lot of the stories and all that have been met so much. I was thinking this morning, Ann mentioned that none of the children's message this morning were here when Justin came. They were all born since then. We challenge you for a new batch for the new pastor, new batch of new people. So Justin's been with us, has been shared through joys and sorrows and sickness and health. We just ask, bless your blessing on him and us as we seek a new pastor, the future. We turn a new chapter in both our lives. It's just exciting to think about the possibilities for us, and we know Justin has great things in mind for himself. We'll just be glad that they will continue to be in our neighborhood and community and available as friendships we cherish so much. We just thank you for and ask your blessing now on them as they go from here and continue in their next chapter in their lives. We ask your blessing and your wisdom. You provided and blessed us in so many ways, and we want to ask a blessing on this meal as we continue to share stories and memories and our fellowship. We ask your blessing on that, and thank you for how you've provided for us good years and bad years and crops and blessings and the support of the church and the ministry and the outreach that it has had in the community and neighborhood in so many different ways. So now as we pause, we want to may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord, may his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May his countenance be lifted upon you and give us peace. We pray these things now in Jesus' name. Amen. It's not because the servers didn't get anything at Easter breakfast, nothing was left. We just want to be there and have everything all laid out for you. We have plenty for everybody, so.